So, are you diabetic or pre-diabetic? Keeping an eye on your blood sugar levels, the glucose levels. In this video, I'm going to tell you about the 6 worst foods, the ones you should definitely dodge at breakfast time. That's because breakfast is super important for managing diabetes. In the morning, when you wake up and start your day, certain hormones which raise blood sugar levels are naturally high, like cortisol, adrenaline, glucagon, and growth hormone. If you're insulin resistant, like in the case of pre-diabetes or type 2 diabetes, insulin won't be able to do its job. And what is insulin's job? It takes the sugar in your blood and gets it into your cells, into your muscles. So, your blood sugar levels could end up being too high. In the case of type 1 diabetes, the same thing can happen, but for a different reason. It's an autoimmune disease. Your body attacks the beta cells in your pancreas, which are the cells that produce insulin. So, your body, your pancreas can't produce insulin, and your blood sugar levels will also be too high. It's crucial for you to eat right, particularly for good management throughout the day. If you eat the wrong foods for breakfast, your blood sugar levels are likely to be high before lunch, and that'll throw things out of whack for the rest of the day. These are the 6 foods to avoid for breakfast. Number 1. Bread with jelly, or bread with margarine or butter. When I say jelly, I mean fruit jelly. It could be strawberry, blackberry, or peach jelly. This type of jelly has lots of sugar, lots of carbs, and it's being put on another carb-filled food, like bread, which is made from white flour. The bread is packed with simple carbs. Double up on that, and it's definitely not good. So bread and jelly for breakfast? Bad idea. This is a common breakfast choice in many households, so you'll want to steer clear of bread with jelly or with butter. Some folks even put butter or margarine on their bread and then toast it. Gives the bread a nice shiny finish. I know, you're thinking, but it's good. I enjoy it. Sure, but if you're diabetic, you gotta steer clear of that sort of food, because it's going to mess up your blood sugar control. Let's talk about butter, for instance, which is full of saturated fats. It not only ups your blood sugar from the carbs in the bread, you're also going to overload on calories. For those keeping an eye on their blood sugar, it's not a smart way to start the day, considering what goes on with our hormones, like I pointed out at the start of this video. So, you should really avoid this kind of diet. Number 2, chocolate drinks. Milk with chocolate, those ready-to-go mixes. Those mixes are just packed with sugars, and you should really avoid. But I'm going to suggest an alternative here. A lot of people mistakenly think is healthy. That's fruit juice, orange juice, grape juice, apple juice, mango juice, or even the blended ones. You add milk to fruits, you end up pulverizing the fibers, and they lose their effectiveness. For instance, if you make an apple blend, apples are a great choice for diabetics, because they're fibrous, have a low glycemic index. But if you make a blended drink, what's going to happen? You lose a good chunk of those benefits. And for diabetics, knocking back grape juice or orange juice or sweetened drinks for breakfast isn't a smart move. Alright then, even if it seems healthy, and the label may even state no added sugars, this kind of juice is highly concentrated, with the fruit's natural sugar. Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying don't eat fruits, but you should aim to eat the fruit with its fibers and low glycemic index ones, like strawberry, guava, avocado, orange with pulp. There are many options, but you gotta watch out for the liquids, okay? Like I mentioned the chocolate milk earlier, many might be thinking, oh, what about skim milk with coffee? The classic cafe au lait. Is it a good choice for diabetics or not? Yeah, there's no big issue. It won't be the thing to spike your blood sugar. I know there are plenty of videos on the internet bashing milk, but that's not backed up by science, unless you're lactose intolerant or have some other allergy related to milk, like if it makes you itch or gives you diarrhea or makes you feel bloated after drinking it. In that case, it's a different story and you should avoid milk. But generally, there's no reason to not have your coffee with milk. It's a good option. I have it almost every day. I really enjoy espresso, but often I just have coffee with skim milk. Skim milk is a better choice since I'm on the topic, because it's lower in calories, lower in fats, so it's better for those on a weight control program and also keeping an eye on their blood sugar levels. Number 3, and another controversial topic, oatmeal. If you're diabetic, you should avoid oatmeal because oatmeal is high in carbs and sugars. Oh, but it's got fiber? Yes, oatmeal does have fiber, but it's high in sugars, simple carbs. If you're watching your blood sugar, you should avoid oatmeal. If you eat it with banana and honey, like many people do, well then it'll spike your blood sugar quite a bit. Bananas themselves have a high glycemic load with a sugar content higher than the average fruit. So it's a fruit that you should avoid. Even without the oatmeal, you should still avoid them. If you pair honey, which also has high sugar content, with bananas and oatmeal, it's one of the worst breakfasts you could choose. So if you're diabetic, avoid oatmeal with those toppings like the ones I mentioned in this video. Number 4, pancakes. Pancakes are high in sugars and carbs and are also not a good option for diabetics to eat first thing in the morning, especially if you add honey or any other syrup that usually comes served with pancakes. You should avoid these kinds of food if you're watching your blood sugar. Number 5, chocolate cake, carrot cake, corn cake. Who doesn't love corn cake? But what's the catch? Since it's a food high in carbs and sugars, if you eat a slice of corn cake, your blood sugar will go up because your body will digest it and the sugar levels will increase. So it's a food you should avoid. Do you usually eat corn cake or any other type of cake? I'm not just talking about those fancy cakes or pastries with sugar on top. Even if you make corn cake or chocolate cake at home, since the ingredients have carbs, it's not a good choice. Number 6, cereal. And for many kids, I know they often eat cereal. Sometimes, in my practice, as I'm a specialist in diabetes, I treat more and more young patients who have a habit of eating cereal, which is a terrible choice for those with diabetes because, in addition to the food being high in carbs, it has more added sugar. It often even comes with a sugar coating and will significantly raise their blood sugar levels. On a scale of 0 to 10, how would you rate this video? If it's a 10, I'll make more videos like this one. Also, write in the comments where you're from.